Hey Pixels! In this week's tutorial, I will be showing you how to code this drop-down menu with HTML5 and CSS3. Before we begin, be sure to visit my blog exopixel.com to see the source files and the completed code for this tutorial. Now, let's begin. First, we're going to code the HTML5. Let's start with the unordered list tag. Within the unordered list tag, we're going to add three individual links on the menu using the list tag. And within the list tag, we're going to add the anchor tag since it's going to be used as a link to other parts of our hypothetical website. For now, we don't have a URL to point the anchor to, so we're just going to put the hashtag as a link placeholder. Once we've written all of our menu links, we're going to write a few lines of code for the drop-down menu. First, create another list with the class Dropdown. Within the link, we're going to add an anchor tag with the class DropdownBTN. Let's label it Dropdown so we know which link will lead to the actual drop-down menu. Now, we're going to create a div and give it the class DropdownMenu. Within this div, we're going to put four anchor tags. For this tutorial, I'm just going to give them descriptive names like link 1, link 2, etc. Well, that's it for the HTML. That was super easy. Double check your code and make sure your opening tags have their respective closing tags and that there's no missing brackets. Be sure to check out my video, 10 HTML coding mistakes if you find you're having trouble with the HTML code. Now, you're ready to move on to the CSS. Okay, so we've coded all of the HTML, and now we're on the last step, which is coding the CSS. Let's get started. First, we're going to select the body tag and add some basic styles to a few common elements, like font family, max width, margin, and padding. Next, we're going to style the unordered list elements. First, we're going to remove the bullets in the unordered list using list style type none. We're also going to reset the margin and padding by setting their value to 0. We'll be setting the overflow property to hidden and making the background color of the menu green. Now, we're going to focus on the list elements. First, we're going to float the list items to the left. Then, we're going to select both the list anchor element and the drop-down BTN element. Selecting more than one element saves time if you're applying the same styles to more than one element. Now, we're going to display them inline block, change the text color to white, align their text to the center, add 18 pixels of padding to the top and bottom, and 22 pixels to the left and right, and remove the default link underline using the text decoration none. Next, we're going to style the list anchor hover, drop-down hover, and drop-down BTN by making the hover background to a light gray and changing the text to the same green we used for the menu. Now, we're going to style the list elements in the drop-down by using the display property and setting its value to inline block. Finally, we're going to style the star of this tutorial, which is the actual drop-down part for this drop-down menu tutorial. To do this, we're going to select the drop-down menu element and style it by setting its display to none. This is to initially hide the drop-down menu. Now, we're going to set its position to absolute, so it's positioned right below the parent anchor link. We'll give it a light gray background color, set its width to 160 pixels, and add a drop shadow to the menu using the box shadow property. Now, we're going to style the drop-down menu's anchors by styling the color of the font gray, adding 12 pixels of padding to the top and bottom, and 16 pixels of padding to the left and right. We'll also set text decoration to none, set the display to block, and align the anchors to the left. We're going to style the anchors when the mouse hovers over them using the Hover Pseudo class and changing their background color to green and the text color to white. Lastly, we're going to select the dropdown element and add the Pseudo class hover to it. We'll also select the dropdown menu element, use the property display, and set its value to block. That way, we only see the drop-down menu items when the mouse hovers over the button. There you have it! You've created your very own drop-down menu. Now go ahead and use what you learned in this tutorial on your other coding and web design projects. Feel free to share this video with anyone that's interested in learning how to code. Give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to ExoPixel for more great videos just like this one. As always, thank you for watching. I'll see you in next week's video.